think Jim Goff would have been to tell us really what he likes there.
I'm sure if we just keep them up to date about what we're doing, that it's going to be on their mind. You'll be briefing her, I'm sure, so that they won't forget. I was going to go on vacation in September.
You didn't say what year.
Now it's really, it's for sure.
That's right. I forgot to say what year.
Well, see, that's the thing. It could be October 15th for all I care. Because it's going to take a while to get all this stuff published.
Well,
should
we?
October sound better?
Pardon me?
October sound better to you?
Well, what steps do we have to take before we can do it? I think if you call the paper on Monday, that you can get it in, not that Friday, but the following Friday, be great for them.
Yeah. And the contact that I have,
so that's about basically
a land period. And Decatur, so.
Perfect.
That the paper, Braceville, Greensburg, and Rushville are all one company. So the gal's actually in Greensburg. So I can get Greensburg's pretty easy, but I don't know.
Yeah, I'll just have to give it to Houston Anderson.
Well, there are companies up at Anderson, but the gal's actually in Greensburg.
Really?
That does the legals.
Let's
see, that's the thing, Bobbers. Goes through for sales. And I don't have any contacts for sale.
Well, do we need to put it in for sales paper, Batesville,
yeah.
Greensburg, and Plainview?
I would just do it in the three counties.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's three counties.
We've got four fingers up. We don't have
one's for sales and one's Batesville.
Yeah, one's Batesville.
Well, normally when we as the county, putting an advertisement in there for quotes or bids. We can usually put it in
the paper.
I noticed it's in there.
Yeah. Because one of them's in the city and the other one's in the county. You know, and Batesville actually happens to just 2 p.m.
Yeah, we're in the
county. Yeah. They're part of the county. City of Batesville.
Well, it's in Ridley and it fails.
So anyway, we probably have to go back and whoever does all that for you would have to get a price and find out, make sure the commissioners are happy with it and get that done.
When we ask the commissioners for money, should we just ask them for enough to do this job? Or should we ask them for $500 from each county so that we got a little bit of money to buy postage stamps?
We don't have a bank. We don't have a bank account. So I don't want to start that. We'll just go to them every time we need it. I mean, it's been pretty quick and dirty every time we've done it so far.
That just reminds me that they're a treasurer.
Who's our treasurer?
Man.
Oh, that's right.
Yes, we do.
That's right.
Yeah.
It was. What's his name the year before?
Reeves
the year before.
Right.
Yeah, or his report is this, right?
And I'm not sure I really want to get it.
Right.
Then that's a whole other issue, reporting.
Right. Keeping track of all that. Yeah.
I wonder if we just have a county and set up a certain amount of this problem
as a budget, more or less.
Well, if you put it in a budget, would be smart.
Yeah.
But I don't know what to tell them to put in a budget.
Yeah.
We're only working on the budget right now.
Well, we start Tuesday. In our county, if you put something in there for it, probably under a separate line item.
Be a line item, right. That's what
I'll do. With it, where if we've got something in the commissioner's budget, then the other commissioners are agreeable to it.
It's strictly the commissioner's expected to do it anytime.
Yeah.
If you don't, if you go through the general, then you got to go through the commissioners and council both. Yeah, I've seen that before.
Oh, yeah.
So what we're doing may be the simplest.
Yes.
I'll thank you.
Thank you right there. If we get the commissioners to do it, give us a line out of the budget. You know what else?
That's the way we could put that with the commissioners. Just turn out a commission for it.
Sure.
We did pay.
So we're going to change it October 15th.
Well, what steps do we need to do? We need to find out how much it will cost.
And then you publish.
Right.
Do we need to let the other two guys make comments about it?
Well, yeah, I wouldn't mind hearing any comments that they have.
Yeah.
Are there any comments tonight about things that you think may be strong enough or not strong enough? I mean, too strong or not strong enough is what I was trying to say.
I used to work for a city, so
it's strong enough. We just got to make sure whoever gets it, we make sure that we give them all the information that we have available and shove it down the throat.
Yeah.
So they're not going out trying to find the same kind of thing.
Yeah.
That's true. And you can establish a relationship with an engineer. Once you go through the RFPs and do the selection process, you may actually want to have three engineers come down here and talk to us before we pick anybody.
Right.
And have them actually tell us what they think they want to do.
Mm-hmm. We have to make sure we're successful in the meetings.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
So, before you call engineers and sit down and talk to them, you need to make sure we get some funds to work.
Well, and that's what we have to go back to IFA and find out if they're going to release some funds. Well, once we get the RFPs, we'll have some pricing and that sort of thing.
Sure. I'm not an engineer, but I think one of my first questions, if I was, do you have funding to pay for these costs?
Yeah. Yeah. Where's the money coming from?
That's mm-hmm. right.
Sure.
Well, should we say in here somewhere that developing a contract would be contingent upon funding? Did you say that?
No. No. Because really, the usually on RFPs, you are not going to talk about how you're going to fund it. That would be in the contract where you sign up.
Okay.
There would be a discussion with the three companies that we decided to interview.
Yeah, and they may ask us that question, and mm-hmm. then they can say yay or nay, whether you want to work for us.
That's true.
But they actually have people hired to answer this kind of stuff. Business development. Unless they cut themselves to the bone like everybody else.
You're right.
So we could be hearing what Dan and Jerome think about this at the same time that we're determining printing costs from the newspapers.
Good. Well, I've seen what happened. Nothing I like was, you know, what they print shouldn't be very similar. It should be, wouldn't it?
It should be.
The cost shouldn't be that much different one way or the other.
Well, they can tell us column inches.
Sure.
Ron, yeah. What would be your email address?
REBLOEMER.
Should we